On today's episode, we're going to take a look at the latest Creality CR10. This is the CR10 version 2. I'm going to go through all the different features, give you my opinion of it, all in today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by these Patreon supporters. This is my collection of CR10, so I do have a background with this machine. This is my original CR10. I've had this for over 2.5 years. It is the first Creality machine I've ever used, and it's one of the first CR10s because I was one of the early reviewers of this machine and I love it. I still to this day love this machine. Prints beautifully. I use it often. This one is a CR10S. This was the upgrade to the CR10. It incorporated things people wanted like dual threaded rods. It's got a filament runout sensor, little plastic thing. It's got 256K memory inside this in a bootloader, so you can upgrade it. Overall though, this machine never really worked well for me. I could never really keep a good level, and it just didn't print as good as the original CR10. This guy is the CR10S Pro. I reviewed this a little while ago. This has auto level and incorporated electronics in the base, has the higher end electronics, plus it has the TMC drivers, so it's very, very quiet. So this 10S is really where this new CR10 V2 comes in, because it shares a lot of features with this guy right here. The CR10 V2 is just like all the other CR10s, very easy to assemble. You can have this thing together and printing in about an hour. It does come with a printed manual, and it covered most of the assembly. It did not cover the rubber feet or the Z stop switch on the side. That's kind of bad if someone's really new. There is a code here that you can connect to their website and get the latest assembly instructions, so it may be covered, but I followed the manual and it didn't have it in here. But they had every other step, like making the connections, setting up your leveling your bed, setting up the slicer. So it's a pretty good manual, just missing a few things. The only real major addition that I saw over the assembly of the other ones were these two rods. And these two rods, you have to screw them together. There's hardware to attach, there's brackets here. They're designed to really stiffen this thing up. But my only argument is I don't see it on the Pro version, and I never used that on my original CR10. I've never had an issue. Vibration on these things has never been a problem. I guess if you're printing really tall and fast, it may be a problem. So I really don't know why they added these. They're there if you want them, but I don't want them. So I just put them there for the picture. I didn't install them and I didn't print with them. So let's take a look at a few of the features. It's got a filament runout sensor, very similar in design to the CR10S Pro. It has a metal extruder, which is a really nice upgrade, because the CR10S and CR10 are plastic. So this is a good upgrade. It has a different hot end. Now it looks like an E3D V6, but it isn't. The PTFE tube goes all the way down to the nozzle, just like all the other Creality machines. To prove it, I shoved the PTFE tube all the way through after I took the nozzle out, and it goes all the way through. So it's not an all metal hot end. It's not a E3D V6, although it's shaped like it. It does have a better fan for cooling and a better ductwork, so a dual ductwork underneath. And then the blower fan is on the side to blow across the fins. So that's a different hot end setup. I'm just not sure it's better. It does have dual threaded rods and dual stepper motors like the CR10S or CR10S Pro, but it does have a glass bed with a ultra base type finish, or you can flip it over and it's pure glass. I like that better than the aluminum and build tech setup on the CR10S Pro. The rest of the changes are inside the electronics box, which is separate like the original CR10, not built in like the CR10S Pro. It does have a meanwell power supply, 24 volts, so it gives you a little more power for heating the bed and the hot end. It does have a newer motherboard, and it has a 256K just like the CR10S. It's got a bootloader. And it's got a standard LCD, not the separate module like the CR10S Pro. So this is actually easier to upgrade or hack if you're into that. The connections themselves come to two cables and then one main one for the hot end. These two cables come to a single connection. So a large one here at the top and then a breakout board, and then one at the bottom to a separate breakout board for the wires. Similar to what the CR10S Pro. So what it does, it makes it easier to assemble, and there's less connections going to the machine, but there's actually more connections because of the breakout board. It definitely has hardware improvements over the CR10, but does the print quality improve? Well, let's print some stuff and see how it does. The first file I printed was their sample CAT file. This is the same file I printed in my original CR10 review, and it looks good. This is their filament, their sliced, sample file. looked really good. So then I printed my CHEP cube, only I upsized it 200% to pronounce the letters more. And I wanted to see how well that cooling would do as far as bridging for the letters. And frankly, it's no different than any other printer I got. So I don't think it's doing that much. I also wanted to see how bad the ringing was with the bed. A glass bed will typically give you more ringing on the side, on the Y side, and there's definitely ringing or ghosting on the Y. So that's typical, but nothing unexpected. Dimensionally, it was really good. So then I printed a couple practical prints, big ones like this. This is a mount. You mount it, screw it to the wall, and it'll hold your Ryobi tool like that. So fits good. The dimensions fit good. Another one like this for screwdrivers and things like this. This actually, some of these are on Thingiverse. I can put a link to it in the description below. But they printed really good, really nice, and the quality is decent for a 0.28 layer height. I just printed it at a 0.28 and it looks good. I printed these cones, and this is actually for a project I'm working on. I got all kinds of stringing between these guys. So I changed the settings, increased the retraction, I still got stringing. So I don't know if it's related to the PTFE tube being too long or the hot end, but I'm definitely seeing a lot more stringing on this machine than I am on either one of my other CR10s. So I think it's a decent printer. The question is it worth the price? $499 is the retail price of this machine right here. Now, you can get an auto level sensor. There's even a mounting spot for it over here. And you can get a direct drive unit to go on top of those. Those are options that will cost you extra, but you can get it on this machine. I didn't get those, so I couldn't review them. So $499 is the unit that I reviewed. Now, for about $100 more, you can get the CR10S Pro with the incorporated electronics and auto level already there. If you want to spend less, for about $100 less, you can get the original CR10. Although Banggood has it for $349 right now, which is a really good deal. But typically, it's about $100 less than this guy. So this fits in between the two, which is what the CR10S did. So that's why I'd say this is a CR10S upgrade, not just a CR10 upgrade. So it's a nice printer. It's a 24-volt system, just like the Ender 3. So if you're looking to upgrade from Ender 3, you might consider it. I don't know, it's really your call. If it fits for $499, I think it's a good machine. I think it's just a bit overpriced.